Hello and welcome to this full tutorial where I show you how to set up recording in Steam, where you can record gameplay footage like you see here, where I've recorded a gameplay capture or footage here of Balatro. It's a game I have in Steam, and then you can also timeline. You can go between the timeline here like you're in a video editor and clip your favorite plays or moments within a game. So we're going to get out of this now. So from start to finish, the first thing that you want to do is open up Steam. And when you're here within Steam, you want to go to Steam, and then you want to go to Settings. And then under Settings, what you want to do is you want to go to Interface. So click on Interface. And then once under Interface, you see where it says Client Beta Participation. You want this to be set to Steam Beta Update. Make sure you get the latest and greatest and the ability to even record and clip your footage going forward. So make sure that is selected there, and you'll have to restart your Steam client. Once you've done that, you will now see when you go into Steam and then go to Steam and then go down to Settings, you're going to see an option now at the bottom that says Game Recording. Now, I'm going to make this a little bit bigger so we can look at everything in totality. So as you see here, there are a number of ways that you can record or set Steam to record your gameplay footage. The first is don't record. That one's obvious. Second is record in background. So it'll basically save up to 120 minutes of video. That way you don't have to worry about pressing the record button and you know, don't miss those awesome opportunities. Now, depending on how much storage you have on your PC, you can go to the length here and you can actually go and increase that to say 240 minutes if that's what you want to do. And then as you can see, I do not have enough hard drive space for that. So I'm going to leave mine at 120 minutes. Now, you can't do both of these at once. So you either have to select record in background or record on demand. So if we select record on demand, you can see that background recording is off. And your old background recordings won't be overwritten with new gameplay. You can delete them to free up space. So you can actually go into your recordings folder, which I'll show you in a second, and actually go and edit and delete them once you're done. Now, the next thing is the raw recordings folder. Where do you want these videos and clips to be stored when you record the gameplay? So it automatically has a general folder here. I've actually renamed a folder of mine to make it much easier to find. So you just click on Change Folder, and then it basically brings up a File Explorer window where you can go anywhere on your PC, create a new folder by right-clicking New Folder, and then just create a folder, go to Select Folder, and that's going to select the folder. Just make sure it's on the hard drive in which you want the clips or video footage stored. So that's how you change the raw recordings folder. Next is the recording quality. Under recording quality, you can see here there's an option from 1.5 megabits per second, which is the lowest, all the way up to the highest, which is 24 megabits per second. I leave mine on the default, which is high, but depending on, again, the power of your PC and the amount of storage you have, you might want to increase that, just knowing that it's going to take up more space the higher that you go. Next is enable GPU hardware encoding. I just leave that checked. Next is shortcut keys. These are very important. Overlay shortcut key to start and stop recording. So the general shortcut command for this is Control plus F11 to start. And then you can add a timeline or a marker to notate, hey, something really cool happened here with Control plus F12. And again, you can change these by selecting this over here and then just typing in or hitting a key on your keyboard to change those. And then a screenshot shortcut key is going to be F12. So again, the one up here is for starting and stopping, and you can see the ones down below. Now, if you're a streamer or someone who has a microphone always hooked up, you can also record your microphone audio. You can enable that by going right here, but a lot of people like to overdub or dub after the fact if you're going to post it to social media or whatever it may be. So the recording audio is going to be from the game audio only, but you can get it from all system or game and selected programs. I'd leave that at game audio only. All right, so we're going to go ahead and go to record on demand, and we are going to go ahead and open up a game of Balatro, one of my favorite games lately. And we're going to go ahead and open the game up here. And once the game is open, you can see that it's not recording because I don't have the recording and background feature on. So in order for me to start recording, I need to hit the hotkey or keyboard shortcut, which is Control plus F11. And as you can see down there in the lower right-hand corner, recording has started. Now, whatever I'm going to do, I start playing the game, I go ahead, something really cool happens. I get a really cool card, a really cool joker, whatever it may be, and I'm like, oh man, that's awesome. Well, I go ahead and hit Control F 12, and that's going to add a user marker or a timeline marker so you know to go back to it in the edit so you're like, oh, that's where that awesome thing happened. Now, when I'm done recording, I just go and I hit Control F11 one more time, and that's going to end or finalize that clip. Now, if I open Steam and go back to Steam here, you can see the easiest way to get to my recordings is to go to View, and then right here you should see something that says Recordings and Screenshots. Go ahead and click into Recordings and Screenshots, and as you can see, anything that's recorded in the background where you have it set up to record everything and you don't start and stop, it'll notate that by saying that's a background recording. Anything that is a clip or something that you started and stopped will show up here with the scissor icon as a clip. You can see the difference in the two there. So we're going to select into that clip here, and what you're going to see is here is the marker that I added. I can jump straight to that in the timeline, and it shows you exactly where that marker is. You can actually go here and edit the name of that marker, giving it a title and description. That way you can jump to and from wherever these cool things happen. Now, when you want to share the clips, you can go here and go to Share with the Share option here, and you can copy the link, you can send to another device, you can send to phone via a QR code, you can export the video file to edit in another video editor of your choice. A lot of really cool features there. And then if you want to, you can clip this. So let's go back now to the background recording that I did earlier before, you know, recording and showing you this video. I can actually go here and select specific start and endpoints. So I can go here and add a marker at the current playback, and then I can go to clip here, and then I can go to save share, and I can save that in Steam as a clip itself individually, or I can export the video file, or I can share it like I showed you earlier. And everything works like a normal video editor. You can click and drag the playhead to get to a certain area. You can clip it. You can go back. You can see here we can start clip at the current playback. You can even zoom in or out of the timeline. Very, very cool. For a first iteration of this, there's a lot of really cool features here. Now, if I go back to our videos here, if you have a whole bunch of recordings here, you can actually sort them by most recent. You can sort them per game. Like I only have one game, which is Balatro right now. You can go to all media. You can sort it by screenshots, clips, background recordings. You can sort it by whatever you want there. And then if you want to delete clips, you go right here and you go to select, and then you select the clip you want to delete, and then hit the trash can icon. And that's really it. That's all you need to know. Just make sure you set it when you go into Steam settings, and then you go to game recording, whether you want it to be in the background and recording all the time, or you want to record on demand. Just make sure you remember what your shortcut hotkeys are, and just remember which one of these settings you have set up, and just know that you can go to View right here, go to View, and then Recordings and Screenshots, and you'll find everything you need right here. Let me know any questions you have down below. If this video helped, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.